I'm happy to be allowed one sentimental item, but any other personal belongings must be cleared with my section commander. Okay, this is Dick. We are going into round one. The lack of removal is really worrying. Are these guys really that powerful that they can just smash face and get through before the war leader arrives, when the angel lands? It should all be good. Yeah. She should be fine. Wow, this is I like the set, but it's hard not to like it in the first few days. And the Legion is marching. Who will be the first enemy of the Boros Legion? Probably another Boros Legion, given how good the Legion is. We shall see. It's Metaghost! And yes, the Legion likes to play first. And the Legion has 1, 2, 4... Oh yeah, that's probably good enough. Stupid me, including 5 and 6 drops. No, I don't want to mulligan. And we got a guild gate up. It's probably another Boros deck. Here's our goblin. Nasties. It's another Boros deck. Okay, now I got a curve nicely here. I think killing the syndicate of that guy should be pretty good. And that will also prevent his battalion. If he blocks, so thus he will not block. And this guy dominates the Syndicate of Tithes. Madcap skills! Sweet, with extort! But two can play that game. And I need to place the Madcap skills on... I really need another mana. I need to place it on the Skinbrand Goblin, because he's the guy that he can actually block. And thus I'm doing 7 points a turn, and I don't think he can extort himself out of that. But I really need the land. I'm playing 17 land and 2 Prophetic Prisms. One toughness feels pretty unsafe with the Skinbrand Goblin. He's quite hard to block. Oh, I would love some mana. All right. Syndicate of Tith, perhaps. Uh-oh! Theorist Act of Treason. That's 10 points of damage for poor me. Which is not insignificant. So what do I do now? I got to block with two creatures, and if I block with Ember Beast and Warmind Infantry, they will succeed in the block, and that's about the only thing I can do. So Skinbrand keeps hitting, and I am very close to extort death, And the cheaper Boros deck wins because you never get the chance to play Foundry Champion or Aurelia the War Leader. So do I just sideboard out the 6 drops? Maybe that's what I have to do. Gift of Orshova. Oh, right. Gift of Orshova, Madcap. I didn't really have any. And you see my fantastic cards in my hand. So, what turn was this? This was turn 5, so there was no chance I could play the War Leader or the Foundry Champion. So I just have to go into Basilica Guards, perhaps. Or at least the Knight of Obligation. Well, I am removing these two guys and going for something cheaper. I think it might be wrong. But I have no defense against that sort of... Yeah, I have to be faster. And it probably is the Knight of Obligation then. So that's what I'm doing. And I'm starting first. And yeah, that's a crappy hand again. I will just die with this hand. It really does nothing. So I have to send it back. I get no land. I have to send it back. And we're going to town with 2 lands, a Skinbrand Goblin, and nothing. There's the Prism. Under these circumstances, I will need to play the Prism. Yeah. Got to draw land. Wow. That's a good card. There is no chance that I can block him. So I will play the Ember Beast. And wow, True Fire Paladin will beat me so hard. 1 white mana for the Knight of Obligation. He will need 4 mana to get through the knight. Wow, Sundawn Guildmage can actually be played. It must be a better play than... A goblin. So he can't get through the Ember Beast. And Bomber Corpse, but blocking with the Guildmage feels really bad. Let's see what we can do. Oh, his cards are so good! We have no defense against the Reckoner except that we do in the Ember Beast. Warmind Infantry, how much for that? Yes. Okay. We are on the defensive, which is super bad. Reckoner will kill the Guildmage if I block with the Ember Beast. Yeah. So I guess I just gonna take it if he attacks. And the True Fire Paladin really sucks. So if I can get to Aurelia, but it looks so very, very hard. And yeah, the Guildmage is gone. And what now? If I block the Reckoner, he clears the board. So I can't really block him. So what happens if I attack? Well, I do some damage. This guy... I do 5, he will do 4, 5, 6, 9. I really have to stay back. Which is not the way to win. The Boros Mirror. Do I still? Yep. Well, I'm on the defensive here, and that really sucks. Just 2 more mana, and we shall speak of war. So, True Fire Paladin, if he finds another plane, True Fire Paladin gets just impossible to handle. And I still need to find 2 more mana for my war leader. And she just sucks. Despite being so good. That's interesting. What a sick, sick format this seems to be. And here they come, all of them, I guess. Though I think that might be a mistake, actually. I'm not sure, it's probably never is a mistake. Deals 1 damage to me. That's so sweet. Okay, he's a 4-2. He can't kill those two guys. So we're gonna block with them. And him. And then they all die. His guys died too, so it's a 3-for-3. And True Fire Paladin is still around to totally wreck my day. One more creature. One creature will be there still, and probably the Warmind then. Can Aurelia even raise the True Fire Paladin? He is truly good. Aurelia will hit for 6. Oh my god. Okay. Well. I don't even want to know how much damage I'm taking here. It's not going as planned. Target creature gains double strike until end of turn. That looks like a useful thing to do. So here I have a good block, but of course that will not work, or maybe it will. So I will give double strike to the Skinbrand Goblin and kill the Reckoner, and that should put us at nothing. Yep. So block,
block.
Permanence you control are indestructible this turn. That looks like the better option, actually. But he's doing some trick. Yeah, he's doing first strike. I'm doing Boros Charm. Still taking 3 damage. So I'm at 4. And now my assault can begin. No, of course it can't. What? Okay, it's a 2-1 that will not get through the assault. It will get through the assault, Griffin. Oh, it will kill someone every turn. That's just broken. So it needs 2 turns to kill me. And I can't kill it. I'm gonna hit for 5, gonna hit for 8. Aurelia is totally impossible. Wow, that guy is good. So what do I do now? Prevent all creatures blocking it. Wow. Yeah, I guess I have to draw something next turn. So I can't just let him kill all my creatures. So I'm gonna take it. And he will kill me, but I don't see any way of winning if I block with everything. And Aurelia, once again, being a total crap about things. And now I have to block. A lot of stuff. 1 mana to the war leader, and now I'm starting to get my hopes up, but I am at 2 life, so almost anything can destroy my hopes. Please just attack with everything, and we'll trade. Oh no, yes, Foundry Champion next turn. Foundry Champion will kill Aurelia. Unless he doesn't attack. Because he's waiting for the Foundry Champion. I draw a land. I attack 2 times. And the situation will be very different. Yeah, I'll just have to block with the Skinburn Goblin. There is nothing else to do, is there? Mana. Well, that's not what we want. And now I present to you Foundry Champion to seal our doom. That's good enough. Where's our rating at? 1746. Dropping like crazy. I have a problem with sealed deck. I have a 67% win percentage in draft, and I have a 51% win percentage in sealed deck. There is a leak somewhere, and I would really like to know what I'm doing wrong, because I'm so bad at sealed deck compared to draft. Well, thank you for watching Magic Gathering Strat, playing the first round of the pre-release.